questions for Chase.
We were just talking to Coach Baldwin about some of the scramble drill plays. And he's saying there's ways, even when you're wearing gold, that you guys can kind of rep those in practice. What are some things that you can do to kind of get on the same page with your receivers and have them work for you in those scramble drills?
So, I mean, 7-on-7 drills or anything where it's just pass only. If something's not there, Coach Baldwin really preaches, you know, roll out of the pocket, really create that true scramble drill that we don't get to work in practice. So I think what you saw on Saturdays is what's carried over from fall camp and spring ball.
What are Coach Tui, Coach Baldwin telling you about kind of in general protecting yourself? Because you have some mobility, but your right arms are pretty important too.
Yeah, I mean, especially on the run, you definitely want to get down, not take unnecessary hits, which, you know, I think I kind of took a little on this past weekend with Idaho State. But yeah, just sliding and diving at angles, trying to make defenders not take that big shot on you.
Is there an instinct in you that wants to try to run through that guy or keep going rather than to go down?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, in high school, I was never a slider or a dive guy. I was always trying to, you know, get out of bounds or run around people. But at the next level, you know, a lot of people are bigger than you are. So especially diving at angles is what I've been working on.
On that touchdown throw to Jake Ashton, what were you seeing, and what's it like to have a guy like him get his first touchdown?
It was awesome. Jake's been here a while. I mean, just to see him catch the ball and make that play was absolutely incredible. So what I saw was nothing was really there at first, scrambled out. Jake had a huge play, you know, running up the field, and the defender lost him, and we connected.
Have you looked at the tape of how easy you made it look?
I mean, we've watched
even
the film.
Your face is like, "Bang, I
did." We've watched the film, yeah, but we executed it pretty well. Yeah.
Do you have fun with that when your teammates get to sit down and see a play like that? Obviously, you guys have worked on some of this stuff and to see it pay off that way.
Yeah, we have lots of fun, you know, breaking down the film the next day and kind of seeing what we did really well and what we did really poorly.
What are some of the things that you guys have a bye week here that you'd like to see the offense work on this week as you guys get ready for conference play?
We need to clean up a lot of things. You know, we had 11 penalties, not entirely on the offense, but we had ones that were crucial that got us out of crucial third downs. And so working on penalties and just executing better.
Just if you look at how many guys you were throwing to on Saturday, you guys have a lot of talent and depth at wide receiver. Is that fun for you as a quarterback?
Oh, it's amazing. Having that much depth and that much talent at wideout is, you know, a quarterback's dream.
Chase, if you go back the last 2.5 games, evaluate, give yourself a grade if you would, and just tell us what you think you've done well and what you're not as satisfied with.
I wouldn't say that well, but you know, we're winning, so that's all we can use. The grade, I mean, I don't know, but you know, I have to be better at my reads, obviously, and making better throws.
Are there some things that you're pleased with besides winning?
Completions have gone up. That's good. You know, as a quarterback, and we're winning, so that's all I can say right now.
Is that really the bottom line for a quarterback?
Yeah, just getting the win. Yeah.
We're here, guys. Talk about the game kind of slowing down. Are you seeing that even week to week or from camp to the game days?
Definitely, you know, week to week, especially from North Carolina to BYU and then BYU to Idaho State, the game has definitely slowed down and it's definitely been beneficial.
Are you feeling more confident back there?
Definitely, yeah.
At what point do you start to feel as confident as you did in high school?
We'll see. yeah, it's a long season, so we'll see.
We were asking Jordan Duncan the other day about who's the vocal guy on the offense, and he had to think about it for a minute and eventually got to some of the quarterbacks. Do you think you need to be a vocal guy as a quarterback, or can you kind of in your even-keeled confidence, can that be the way you lead?
Yeah, I picture myself as a lead-by-example type of leader, not so much vocal, but I think as a quarterback you have to have a little bit of both. So, I mean, definitely working on my vocal leadership skills is definitely a thing I want to work on.
Is that the kind of thing that's a little hard to do at the beginning, that you sort of have to grow into that role?
For sure. Being a young guy, especially on an offense that has a lot of veterans, you know, you have to earn the respect to be a vocal leader.
You can't just start screaming at McCary.
Yeah, you definitely can't do that.
All right. Feels good.
Thanks so much, Chase.